A Lithuanian court has cleared students carrying swastikas of illegally bearing symbols of Nazism. The judge's ruling that the emblem is merely a sign with an ancient history has caused anger. Critics fear it's another step towards the rehabilitation of fascist sympathisers. RT's Alexei Yereshevsky reports from Lithuania.
Is this really just an effort to promote an archaeological symbol? A question asked by many Lithuanians after a group of students marched through several cities of the Baltic state carrying placards with swastikas. We turned to the event's organizer for an answer.
I wanted people to think outside the box. That's why I decided to look for a symbol which would urge them to do so. And I chose the ancient swastika, a symbol of light, fire and the universe, as a perfect match. The swastika, once a sacred symbol, is now being misinterpreted and humiliated.
It is, of course, etched forever in history as the sign of Nazi horror. But the march's organizers said the symbol of Nazism was around long before Hitler. We searched the streets of Vilnius for proof.
This is not headquarters of the SS. This balcony with swastikas belongs to a 19th century building in the heart of Vilnius, the Lithuanian capital. Historians say that swastika as a symbol is very popular in this part of the world, and it's been like that long before Adolf Hitler was born.
A professor in the city says the swastika was an ancient symbol of fire and sun in places including China and Europe, even appearing on the first Soviet banknotes.
I've come across swastika a lot in decades of archaeological research. They can be found as decorations for ancient wallets, on clay pots and hats, and they are thousands of years old.
But he is opposed to the marchers' revival of the symbol, notorious as the emblem of the Nazis. He questions their motivation in choosing a motif bonded in the public mind to a creed of extermination and hatred, rather than ancient history.
It's one thing when something is an ancient symbol of fire and prosperity. It's another when somebody tries to use it for whatever their motivation is. I don't believe they did it for their archaeological purposes.
And at first, the Lithuanian authorities thought the same way. The students were originally arrested and put on trial for the illegal display of fascist symbols. But in a court decision which surprised and shocked many, they were acquitted. The judge saw no malicious intent in their actions, believing their story that they were promoting a historical symbol. A leading political activist says it's an extremely sinister and dangerous development for his country.
We see in Lithuania the process of rehabilitation of Nazi collaborators. It will be possible to draw swastikas by some painters, and these painters will be in a position to say that, well, this is after court decision.
In Lithuania, the display of both Nazi and Soviet symbols is outlawed. But many are wondering if the court's verdict may open a way for neo-Nazis to use history as a cover-up for fascist demonstrations. Alexei Roshevsky, RT, reporting from Vilnius in Lithuania.